In this video, I will be showing you how to download and install Gamejolt games from the client. You can find timestamps, links, and a written transcript in the description and comments section below. So we will want to get started by going to the Gamejolt website. To get the client, we'll need to head to the top left of the website and click on these three dots. Then select client to continue to the next page. From here, we can select download for Windows, which will open up a new window where we can save our game. For this tutorial, I will be using the desktop, but you can save the installation file wherever you prefer. You'll also be able to download Gamejolt for Mac and Linux, but I am not familiar with those OS, unfortunately, but it should be somewhat similar to Windows in how we set it up. Now we can go to our download location and then start up the .exe installation app by double-clicking on it. You'll be taken to the setup page and we can see that it will install onto your C drive by default. If you wish, you can click on Browse and select a different location or another storage device. I'll continue with this location, so let's press Next. After the client has finished extracting, it should create a shortcut icon on your desktop as well as automatically start up the client. Here is where you will log in by entering a username and password. At the bottom left of the page, you can change your language to make things easier. Hopefully, your language is on this list. For the client, you will need to have an account by either creating one or you can choose to sign in with your Google, Facebook, Twitter, or Twitch account. I'll go ahead and show how to set it up creating a fresh account. Let's click on sign up at the bottom right, and in the next section, we can use our email, create a username, and finally enter a password. After signing up, you will have to prove you aren't a robot by clicking this box. It will bring up some images you can click on. So for me, it is cars. Yours may be different. And once that is done, we'll now have to verify our email address before we can log in. Head over to the email that you signed up with, and in your inbox should be an email from Gamejolt that looks like this. Sometimes it might be in your spam folder, so be sure to check there. And once you find it, click on authorize. We'll be able to head back to our client, which should have the initial things to set up, like your avatar and communities you may be interested in. You can always do this later if you don't feel like doing it at the moment. At the top of the client, you can find the search bar similar to the website. Typing in a specific game or letter will bring up results. Explore brings you to the front page where you can browse through the many games available. So let's find a game to install. Once you have one that you like, click on it and you will be taken to the author's page. Select the install button and it will start downloading. And after it is all said and done, the last thing to do is just click on the game to launch it up and start playing and having fun. But some games might not be able to be downloaded if they were either taken down or the client, as it is still in pre-release, maybe buggy when trying to run it. If that happens, then try to download it and install it manually from the website. You can find out how to set up your game manually by watching this tutorial that I created. If you do manage to install your game but can't start it up, go to your installed games by clicking the three lines at the top left of the client, click on installed games, select these three dots, and then choose to open a folder for that specific game. This will open up your Windows Explorer where you can select the .exe app and start up your game. If you have any issues or questions, then post them in the comments section below. I will try to do my best in helping you. You can also contact Gamejolt support at contact@gamejolt.com as well if you have a more specific problem. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and leave a like so YouTube can bump it up for others to see. Until next time, everyone, stay safe and take care.